I'm Kelley Allen with Soybean Uni Cooperative. I am a crop advisor working in Eastern Ontario. I've been involved in agriculture for most of my life. And today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about harvesting soybeans at the optimal stage. Soybeans was introduced to Eastern Ontario and Quebec in the 1970s as a forage crop. And now here we are 50 years later, and it's an important row crop for grain production for growers in our area to provide grains for oil production, for specialty human consumption products, and for livestock feed, both for domestic and export markets. Come with me, we're going to take a look in the field and check the stage. So with the soybean plant, we're looking for the R8, reproductive 8 stage of maturity. The soybean plant can move very quickly from R6 to R8. R6 is full pod development and all green. And the R8 stage that we have here today is full pod development and dry, and the stem is brown in color. The pods are yellow or brown, and the seeds inside the pod are detached from the inside of the pod itself. If we take up some pods and split them open, they should pop right out of the casing of the pod and be easy to thresh. Now, if there is some green pods throughout the field, that means a little more time would be needed to make sure that it's a even and uniform harvest. The other thing you could do is do the bite test. You bite into the seed and it cracks in half, then it's ready to harvest. With the weekend's rain we just had, this took on too much moisture, so it's going to take a little more time. And the leaf drop should be at 100%. There shouldn't be any leaves left on the plant when it comes time to harvest. With the soybean plant, we're targeting full maturity for the harvest of the plants. If we harvest them too early, then we'll have too many green pods, green seeds that might cause dockage at the elevator. If they're too dry, then we might get shattering of the pods during the harvest, and that means they're going to land on the ground instead of going through the combine. It also might cause splitting of the seeds, which would increase dockage as well, and we're losing tonnage as well if they're too dry. Soybeans harvested at 9% would lose tonnage compared to soybeans harvested at the optimal 13%. So the target we're reaching for is 13% moisture of the soybean grain, and that's a moisture that's stable in storage and in transport. If there's any question about the moisture of the plant, what you can do is do a test with the combine and take a sample to your seed retailer, take it to a grain elevator handler, or we could take a sample from the combine and do a portable moisture test in the field. Let's take a little walk and make sure that it's uniform in other parts of the field. We're seeing the same thing as we did earlier, complete maturity R8 from the bottom of the plant to the top. They're all at the same stage of maturity. There are stages when the soybeans get too dry and a light rain or morning dew could work in your favor to add tonnage to your soybean harvest, but on the other hand, if it's it could cause more lodging due to adverse weather, heavy rain or snow. So if the stage is correct, harvest away. Better safe than sorry. Now, once we have a sample out of the combine, we could do a moisture test right here in the field. So let's go and check it out. We have our sample of the soybeans we harvested and took out of the combine. Here is a typical portable tester that we use on the farm and in the field. So we're going to do our test right here. It is set for soybeans. Do a quick calibration first. add our soybeans to the cell. And run the test. These are soybeans that are ready to harvest. I'd like to thank you for taking your time to watch this video today. I hope it helps you understand the importance and optimal timing of the harvest of soybeans. If you have any questions or comments, please add them in the chat box below or talk to your Solio expert advisor. Happy harvest, everybody!